Item number, SCP-256. Object class, Euclid. Special containment procedures. SCP-256 is contained within a cubic chamber 3 meters or 10 feet on a side, with 1 meter or 3 feet thick walls, composed of a mixture of brick and rubberized layers, with 2 conductive rods sticking out 18 centimeters or 7 inches from the walls to either side of the entrance. Entrance is restricted by a soundproof airlock. Chamber is to be constantly under surveillance by EMR device and video camera. Entry and surveillance are restricted to only authorized personnel who have undergone surgical adaptation to resist the effects of SCP-256. Personnel not on this list may enter if they are security clearance level 3 or above, but must wear sound-canceling earphones. All personnel must be stripped of all electronics, ferrous metals, and conductive material. They are also required to wear a specially designed insulated and redirective bodysuit, hazmat-alike, which must be tested before wearing, before entrance, and after exit, with a significant charge. A taser is supplied and is rated high enough for testing use. The only recording allowed, aside from the EMR device, is done by hand. SCP standard office paper is suitable, but writing instruments must be non-conductive. Crayons are kept on hand. Description. Move to Site 76 on 3-2-2007. SCP-256 is similar to a typewriter in most respects, except that the keys are fixed in position, rather than connected to levers, and instead of a roll bar in most of the machinery that should be present, 2 concave copper discs stand on either end, facing inward, 38 centimeters or 15 inches apart, while invisible to the naked eye. EM readings show that a significant electrical charge passes between the copper discs without any conductive medium. If any of the prohibited items are brought into the containment chamber, this current increases in both amplitude and voltage, eventually arcing out and striking the object in question. This is also the reason reinforced concrete was not used in the chamber's construction, as rebar seems to agitate the artifact. It is unknown where the extra energy comes from, or even the initial current, as there seems to be no power generation source within SCP-256. If at any time this current oscillates more than the average peak of 26% on the EMR surveillance, all unauthorized personnel, regardless of clearance level, must immediately evacuate the chamber. Those who fail to comply are to be terminated at once, again, regardless of security clearance. For further information, see File 256-B. Open file, 256-B. Displaying authorization list. Agent 76-8947. Agent 76-3465. Agent 76-2456. Agent 76-8638. Agent 76-4634. Scientist 76-2464. Scientist 76-4363. Scientist 76-6521. Scientist 76-3215. Classified. Base Command 0776-0103. Deceased. Access File 256-B. Sysadmin Override 4498. Implementing System Administrator Override will trigger Containment Protocol 289. Security will be alerted to your override and be dispatched to detain you. Termination will commence in 24 hours, unless authorized or repealed by active base command. Proceed. Yes or no? Yes. Confirm security code. Sysadmin 76-4498. System override acknowledged. Base command 0776-1389 has not authorized. 24-hour countdown engaged. Open file 256-B. Displaying authorization list. Previous list of agents and scientists unchanged. Added. Marianne Waters. Civilian. Robert Waters. Civilian. James Turtle. Civilian. Base Command 76-0103. Deceased. Access record. Marianne Waters. Marianne Waters. Suspected mother of item number SCP-256. You have not accessed this terminal in 3 minutes. Do you require assistance? No. Acknowledged. Access record, Robert Waters. Robert Waters, suspected father of item number SCP-256. Access record, James Turtle. James Turtle, discovered item number SCP-256. Claims to be romantically involved with item. Activate security alarm 58B, override sysadmin 76-4498. Security alarm activated. Security dispatched. Access 256C. Access denied. File rated for base command or higher. Access 256C. Override sysadmin 76-4498. From HR_76-5974. 2. Base command 76-1389. Let me officially give you congratulations on your promotion, General Trent. It's a sad, sad thing that happened to your predecessor, but such is the way of things when working for the Foundation. Regardless, I looked into the various classified files that General Gerhardt had under lock and key with your access codes, and found out some really surprising things about SCP-256. First off, the list of authorized personnel are not surgically adapted in any way. In fact, many of them have never undergone anything more serious than the mandated physical. And civilians. Tsk tsk. I can't even begin to understand why General Gerhardt let them even know of the base. Containment agents have been dispatched to see how far their psychosis has progressed, and how much they know. But from what I've found in the late General's personal files, he supposedly had them convinced this was some kind of hospital. Second, as you may have guessed from the notes on the civilians and the highly classified paper manuscripts, the authorized personnel seemed to believe quite vehemently that SCP-256 was once a young adult human named Elizabeth Waters, and has been somehow trapped in the artifact. Even the General was convinced. And the very fact that the base command was compromised by the item's delusions makes me worry about the entire facility. All personnel on the authorized list have been placed under covert surveillance. It is unknown how far the item's control over them goes, and I will be personally reviewing all other SCP security measures enacted on General Gerhardt's behalf. Third, there is information on the artifact that has not been made available in the report. Firstly, the variance on the EMR is remarkably similar to an oscilloscope's pickup of human voice. Apparently, when SCP-256 starts its variance, it somehow starts producing audio with it. Second, the compromised personnel write down in the manuscripts that the delusions claim to be in pain when metal is brought near it. After an audio recorder was brought into the room, the afflicted agents noted that the delusions ceased for several days, and when they resumed, they indicated that it nearly killed the artifact. Needless to say, I cannot confirm or deny these rumors due to the security restraints on SCP-256, but I do not place credibility in them. Simply put, General, this was a cover-up. Recommend immediate disciplinary procedures for all personnel involved. In regards to SCP-256, I recommend research into power production. As long as the research personnel observe the listed sound blanking procedures, any possible auditory contamination can be contained. There was no listed drop in power when the little girl almost died, and more conductive material may serve to permanently suppress the risk of the artifact. However, as per your new policy with advanced timetable on the destruction of destructible SCP items, I have scheduled the item for a tentative destruction on the 15th of January, 2008, your vigilant officer, Edward Burstrom. You have not accessed this terminal in 3 minutes. Do you require assistance? No. Does the black moon howl? No. The quick brown fox jumps over the lazy dog. Password confirmed. Date, Monday, January 14th, 2008. Query countdown. Countdown to termination for sysadmin 76-4498. Query location, base command, 76-1389. Override, sysadmin 76-4498. Base Command 76-1389 is currently in his office. Activate Security Alarm 136C. Override Sysadmin 76-4498. Security Alarm activated. Security dispatched. General Network Alert. Warning. Sysadmin 76-4498 may be fabricating alarms to distract security. All personnel report sightings immediately. You have not accessed this terminal in 3 minutes. Do you require assistance? General Network Alert. Warning. Sysadmin 76-4498 is to be terminated on site. Sysadmin is armed and dangerous. You have not accessed this terminal in 3 hours. Do you require assistance? General Network Alert. Warning. Site 76 lockdown initiated. All SCP rooms sealing. General Network Alert. All Level 1 and 2 personnel are to proceed directly to designated containment breach defense points and arm themselves. Follow direction of Level 3 personnel. General Network Alert. Explosion detected in Human Resources office. Security has been dispatched. You have not accessed this terminal in 4 hours. Do you require assistance? System override. Containment Protocol 289 has been temporarily suspended by Base Command, *1-0001. You have not accessed this terminal in 5 hours. Do you require assistance? General Network Alert. Base Command, 76-1389 has been relieved of duty by Base Command, *1-0001. Access codes are now suspended. General Network Alert. Site 76 lockdown disengaged. Initiate reclamation and SCP update process. General Network Alert. Check arms back at designated containment breach defense point. Return to standard duties. General Network Alert. Sysadmin 76-4498 is no longer pending termination. You have not accessed this terminal in 6 hours. Do you require assistance? System override. Containment Protocol 289 has been rescinded. Authorization. Approved. You have not accessed this terminal in 7 hours. Do you require assistance? Log off. Does the Black Moon howl? Log off. Override. Base Command, *1-0001. Good night, Director. Lesson complete. If you missed the previous orientation, go watch SCP-255, Base 11 Disorder, right now. Or for the complete course, watch this playlist.